Hello, my name is Andrey Durbach. I'm the chef and owner of Ultra Buca restaurant, where we are here today making fresh squid ink tagliatelle from scratch by hand. So let's get going. We'll start with our eggs and our flour. A good standard ratio of eggs to flour is one egg per 100 grams of flour. Should make you really quite a nice pasta, so that's what we're going to use here today. But in addition to our eggs, some of this fresh squid ink. You'll need, you know, like a pretty good tablespoon of squid ink. Squid ink dishes usually you'll find on the sort of the central and southern end of the Adriatic coast. It's a real true Mediterranean product. 300 grams of all-purpose flour. All-purpose flour seems to work for a lot of people, and it works for me as well too. If you want to spend 6 or 7 times the amount of money, you can go out and get the special pizza and pasta flour that's called a Doppio Zero or 00 that we grow here, send to Italy for refining, and then they send back to us. If you want to do that, go ahead, be my guest. Then you got to kind of see how wet it is. And this is maybe just a little tiny bit wet. So it is better to be too wet than too dry. You can incorporate flour in, but it's hard to put another egg in when it looks like this. And then we're just going to knead it, you know, gathering in the flour. So when you have a texture that looks pretty much like this, where you can actually pull it pretty hard before it starts to bust. Okay, that's a good amount of flour. So now what you would do is you'd continue to knead this for about 10 or 15 minutes. We're going to take our squid ink pasta that's been kneaded for 15 minutes and that has rested for a minimum of half an hour. After you knead your pasta, you have to rest the pasta. What we're going to do now is we're going to make sheets, like rectangular sheets, and we're going to roll it through the machine a few times to determine how thick or thin your pasta is. So we'll start at number 7 here. So once you get something that looks like a rectangle here, then you can start moving your number down a little bit. Okay, so here we are. So that's the last rolling, and you see now like you've got, I mean it's pretty thin now, hey? So if you really get that stretchy elastic quality to your pasta, you know that you've done it right, okay? We're going to hook up our tagliatelle cutter here. Well, you can either cook them right away, which will give you a spongier texture, or you can leave it in a cool, dark place to dry overnight. So that's the processing of the noodles. Now I'm going to show you what we do with them. Grombo with tomato fonduta, squid ink tagliatelle, baby artichokes, Mediterranean vegetables, and olive oil. There you have it.